While combat isn't really the focus of my game, I feel like it's important to make sure that it still feels fun to play the parts that do have combat. For the kind of game that I'm making, I think the trick is to keep things simple. In this video, I'm going to talk about how combat works in my game. At the moment, I have four different kinds of enemies: shooters, bombers, chargers, and bouncers. The vibe of the game is meant to be a little goofy, so I've chosen to theme the enemies to go along with that. Shooters are cowboys that shoot at you when they see you. Bombers are pirates that throw bombs at you. Chargers are football players that charge at you. And bouncers are bouncing on a pogo stick. When they see you, they do a kind of a big bounce to your location. Each of them have their own specific method of attack, but for the most part, they share similar behaviors. And the way I've implemented these behaviors is with a finite state machine. If you're unsure what a state machine is, then don't worry too much. All you need to know is that it's a design pattern that helps us only run parts of the code that are relevant to what the enemy is currently doing. So our boomer enemy, for example, has five states: patrolling, bombing, looking around, hurting, and defeated. It can only ever be in one of these states at a time. This makes reasoning about the logic easier and the code simpler. The patrolling state only needs to navigate its owner to a given path and then follow it. If it sees the player, then it emits a signal which can be handled by the owner code. In the case of boomers, we change to the bombing state. Keeping things simple and generic like this means these states can be shared into other enemies. Like I mentioned earlier, all of the enemies share most of these same states. The two rules I've followed to keep these states shareable are: number one, use dependency injection. States use export variables to tell you what nodes they need to perform their function. Patrolling, for example, requires a navigation agent node, a player detector node, and an animation director node. Using export variables for these means the state can be reused in different kinds of enemies without a bunch of conditional logic. And the second rule of states is that no state refers to any other state. All states do is emit signals when things happen, and then the owner node of the state machine can determine what to do. This makes sure you never end up with spaghetti coupling between states. And before you say, "But Nathan, can't I just use dependency injection to tell a state about another state?" I'll tell you that while I wouldn't do it like that, I'm not the boss of you, so you can do what you want if that works for you. Now, if you want to build a state machine, then you can follow the GD Quest guide on state machines. A link to that is in the description. If you're a patron of mine, then you can get a copy of my state machine over on my Patreon. A link to that is also in the description. Mine is a little different to the GD Quest one. I prefer using Godot conventions, so mine works more closely with Godot's own hooks. And while I'm talking about my Patreon, you can also get a copy of my animation director node there too. What it does is take the directional animations defined in an animation player and collapses them into a single key for each one. Then you tell it a base animation name and it will work out which actual animation it should be playing based on the current direction it's pointed at. In the past, I was using an animation tree to do something similar, but I found it to be cumbersome for what I needed and the effort required to set it up wasn't worth it. This animation director covers my needs and doesn't require any setup other than pointing it at an animation player that follows some simple naming conventions. The animation director also sets its own rotation to match the direction it's facing, which I use to set the vision shapes for enemies. So, back to state machines. I'll show you through each enemy type and what each state does, but this isn't a tutorial, so I'm not going to go into too much detail of the actual code. First, let's revisit the boomer. Boomers start in the patrolling state and follow a path 2D. When the player can be seen, they change to the bombing state, which has them throwing bombs at the player. When the player has left their vision, they enter the looking around state, which tells them to run to where they last knew the player to be and have a look around. If they see the player along the way, they re-enter the bombing state, otherwise they go back to patrolling. If they are ever attacked, they enter the hurting state, which just makes them invulnerable for a given time before returning to the previous state. Once they run out of health, they enter the defeated state, which creates this starry popping effect. Shooters have all the same states except for swapping the bombing state out for a shooting state. When they see the player, they enter the shooting state, which plays the shooting animation and fires the projectile towards the player. Chargers are mostly the same too. They have their specialized charging state, but also have a dazed state for when they run into something while charging. Bouncers are, you guessed it, mostly the same too. Even though their bouncing movement pattern is a little different from the way all of the other enemies move, they still make use of the same core states. They can still patrol along a path just like all of the other enemies. You can see the benefit of designing behaviors so that they can be reused like this. It saves a bunch of time when adding each new enemy type. And all that saved coding time I've been spending on animating these enemies. The animations are all pretty smooth and are drawn in 8 directions. But that's probably for another video. But now, I have a few more ideas for some other enemy types, so I'll get back to it. If you have any thoughts on state machines, then drop a comment below or join my Discord and have a chat. And if you want a copy of my state machine and my animation director, then become a patron. I'll see you all again soon. Bye.